Hello, I'm Hiroki Furue. I'm going to talk about a new variant of Unbalanced oil and vinegar using Quotient link QR-UOV. This is joint work with Yasuhiko, Ikematsu, Yutaro, Kiyomura, and Tsuyoshi, Takagi. First, I'll show a contribution of this research. Multivariate public key crypt systems are candidates of post-quantum crypto systems, and UOV is one of such multivariate signature schemes. In this research, we proposed a new variant of UOV, quotient link UOV, which utilizes matrices corresponding to elements of a quotient link. Compared with Rainbow, variant of UOV, QR-UOV reduces public key size from 50 to 70%. This is the outline of my presentation. First, let me talk about multivariate public key crypto systems. Post-quantum cryptography is a crypto system secure against quantum computers, and there are several candidates like this. In this presentation, I talk about this multivariate polynomial cryptography, which is constructed based on the MQ problem. Given a system of multivariate quadratic equations with n variables and m equations over the finite field with q elements, and then the MQ problem is a problem solving the given system, fx equals 0. This problem is proven to be NP-complete, and hence is considered to be secure against quantum attackers. Next, about UOV signature scheme. Unbalanced oil and vinegar, which is called UOV, is one of the multivariate signature schemes, and it has withstood various attacks for about 20 years. Actually, Rainbow, which is one of the variants of UOV, was selected as one of the third round finalists of the NISPQC project. UOV is highly evaluated for its small signature and short execution time. But it has a problem that its public key size is much larger than other candidates of PQC. Here, we briefly explain the key generation step of UOV. First, we generate an easily invertible quadratic map F, such that each polynomial Fk is designed to be this form. At least one variable of each quadratic term is from x1 to xv. Then here v is said to be equal to n minus m. Second, randomly choose an invertible linear map S in order to hide the structure of F. Finally, the quadratic map P is given by composing F and S. And then the public key is P, and the secret key is F and S. In UOV, given a message M to be signed, we generate the signature S by computing S inverse F inverse M. And verification is performed by confirming whether M equals PS or not. Here I explain a way of inverting F. First, we randomly fix the values from x1 to xv, and then the remaining system becomes a linear system of M equations in M variables due to the structure of the central map F, and we can solve it easily. If there is no solution to this equation, and then return to step 1 and choose new random values. This is an example for the central map F of U of V. Here, Q equals 3, N equals 4, M equals 2, V equals 2. And actually, these two polynomials, F1 and F2, do not involve quadratic terms of X3 and X4. When we solve this equation, Fx equals 0, 1, first randomly fix x1 and x2 to 0, 2, then the polynomial becomes a linear system and x3 and x4 are easily found to be 1, 2. As a result, the solution of this system is 0, 2, 1, 2. Next, I introduce the representation matrices for the public and the secret keys of U of V. When we assume the order of the finite field is odd, the polynomial Fi of the central map F is represented by an n times n symmetric matrix Fi, like this. And then every lower right submatrix of Fi become zero matrix. Since this part represents coefficients of quadratic terms in m variables from xv plus 1 to xn. The linear map S is also represented by n times n matrix S, like this. And furthermore, the quadratic polynomial Pi of the secret key, public key P is represented by n times n symmetric matrix Pi. And this Pi is obtained by S transpose Fis from the equation P equals Fs. Next, about our proposed quotient ring U of V. Here I introduce polynomial matrices. Let L be a positive integer and F be a polynomial in FQX with degree L. Then, for any element G in the quotient ring FQXF, we can uniquely define L times L matrix phi GF over FQ satisfying this equation. For example, if Q equals 2, F equals x cubed plus x plus 1, and then for any element and G equals ax squared plus bx plus c, phi gf is determined like this form. Here, this matrix can be represented by only three elements a, b, c, and so if we can apply such a phi to the representation matrices Pi for the public key of U of V, then we will be able to reduce the public key size. From the definition of the polynomial matrices, the map from G to phi GF is an injective ring homomorphism like this. So, if we assume that the secret key of U of V are set as block phi GF matrices, which is block matrices whose every component correspond to phi GF, and we then wonder if the public keys Pi are also block phi GF matrices or not. But to compute the public key Pi, S is transposed like this. So for that Pi become block phi GF matrices, this phi GF must be stable under the transpose operation. To solve this problem, we introduce the concept of L times L invertible matrix W, such that for any G in FQXF, W phi G is symmetric. Here, we suppose that Fi are constructed as block W phi GF matrices, and S is constructed as block phi matrix. Then, through the transformation like this, we obtain that Pi are block W phi GF matrices. Now I showed that actually there exists such a matrix W. This proposition shows that if F equals x to the power of L minus A, x to the power of I minus 1, and W is L times L matrix like this form, and then for any G in the quotient ring, W phi GF is symmetric. Actually, if Q equals 2 and F equals x cubed plus x plus 1, then for any element G equals x squared plus bx plus c, phi gf is determined like this, and W phi gf becomes symmetric by using W determined by this statement. In the case of F equals x to the power of L minus 1, then the matrix phi GF is a circulant matrix like this. Actually, there exists a variant of UOV using circulant matrices, which is called by block and circulant UOV, BHUOV. BHUOV reduces public key size by applying these circulant matrices. But the attack utilizing the property of the circulant matrices was proposed at 2020. The attack on BHUOV utilizes the property that the sum of the elements of every row and column is the same as those of other rows and columns. By using this property, we can execute the transformation like this. For any circulant matrix, we multiply this symmetric matrix whose every element of the first row and column is 1, and other diagonal elements are minus 1 from both sides, and then it becomes this form whose every element of the first row and column is 0 except the 1-1 element. About this security problem, in this theorem we show that if F is a reducible polynomial and W is an invertible matrix that makes W phi GF symmetric, then there is no L times L matrix L and IJ such that for any G in the quotient ring, the IJ element of L transpose W phi GF L equals 0. This theorem indicates that if we choose f as an irreducible polynomial in a proposed variant, then it will be resistant to the attack on BHUOV. On the other hand, if f is reducible, then there exists such a transformation. Actually, in the case of circulant matrices, x to the power of L minus 1 is reducible like this, and thus there exists a transformation shown in the previous page. Now we explain the key generation of our proposed scheme QR-UOV. First, we choose an irreducible polynomial f of the form x to the power of L minus X to the power of I minus 1, and L times L matrix W such that for any element G in the quotient ring, W phi GF is symmetric. Second, the representation matrices Fi for the central map are designed to be block W5GF matrices, and S is designed to be a block phi matrix. And then the representation matrices of the public key Pi are computed by this equation Pi equals S transpose FiS, and every Pi becomes a block W5GF matrix. Like this figure, every block of Pi is W5 matrix, and it can be represented by only L elements. So, n times n matrix Pi it can be represented by only n squared over L elements. As a result, this reduces the public key size. In this research, we propose parameters of QR-UOV considering some transformations over the OFQL. In this table, we compare the public key and signature size for our proposed QR-UOV parameters and with those for compressed rainbow, which is an optimized variant of rainbow for security level 1, 3, and 5 for the NIST PQC project. As a result, the public key size of QR-UOV can be reduced by approximately from 50% to 70% and compared with that of compressed rainbow at the cost of a small increase in the signature size. And please note that although the public key size could be further reduced by setting the block size L larger, enlarging the block size would likely increase the signature size and the execution time. About the security of QR-UOV, we confirmed that the proposed parameters satisfy the requirements for each security level like this. In this table, we consider the complexity of existing attacks and some attacks utilizing the quotient ring structure of QR-UOV, such as this pullback and lifting attacks. For more details, please see table 4 in the proceeding. Finally, I conclude this presentation. In this research, we propose a new variant of UOV using polynomial matrices, and it reduces the public key size from 50% to 70% compared with rainbow. Our future works are extending QR-UOV to a multi-layer version of the QR rainbow and optimizing implementations. That's all. Thank you for listening.